Everybody, it's McKenna, your Mac mentor, and today we're going to be checking out how to download and use iCloud for your Windows computer. So the cool thing about iCloud for your Windows computer is it makes it super easy to transfer documents and photos back and forth from your iOS device. Now we can always use iCloud.com to do this as well, however I find it just quite a bit easier to use the iCloud application. So of course we'll want to first get started by installing iCloud. So if we have Windows 10 or newer, we can do this using the Microsoft Store. Although if we do have a version later than 10, we'll have to do it using the Apple website. So let's go ahead and do it using the Microsoft Store here. We'll just want to go to our search bar, type in Microsoft Store. This should pop up pretty easily. So then once we get into our Microsoft Store here, there's a search bar in the top right-hand corner. Want to click on that and then enter iCloud. And when we see the iCloud icon pop up, we'll just want to click on it there. And then on the right-hand side here, it'll give us the option to install. So as you can see on the left-hand side here, it does say that I own this app because I do already have it installed. But if you don't yet have it on your computer, you won't see this. So after we've got iCloud installed, it'll ask us to sign in. And after we sign in with our Apple ID, we'll see on the left-hand side here, it'll show our name and our email. And then we'll have options for what we want to sync onto our Windows computer. So as you can see, I've got iCloud Drive and Photos checked here. So those are the two items that it's going to sync. From there, navigating to your files and photos are pretty easy. You just go to your files, and then on the left-hand side there, we see iCloud Drive with all my iCloud Drive folders. And then if we scroll down, we'll see iCloud Photos, and when we click on that, it'll pull up our iCloud Photos. And I do have a lot of photos here, so it'll take forever to download them, but depending on how many photos you have, it may take a little less time. And so once we do have it downloaded and all set up, we're free to import and export files and images, videos from there, and then we can also put them onto the cloud from our computer. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below or check out our website at mymacmentor.com. Don't forget to like and subscribe.